When a dream comes true, I do not believe that we should just rest on our laurels and keep celebrating that for too long. I feel that the fulfillment of a dream is only a stepping stone to work towards the fulfillment of yet another. So I want us all, authors and winners, and my dear colleagues and co-dreamers, who will forever be the original Write India family. There will be many more seasons, there'll be many more authors linking up with us, there'll be many more winners, but this is it. This is the original Write India family. I want you to keep, let us, all of us, keep dreaming more, striving more, succeeding more, and offering the world some more all the time. With this, I would like to invite on stage our celebrity authors, the dream merchants we all have to thank for the enthusiastic support that they came to Write India. These authors will then call their individual winners who will be felicitated by the authors. I call upon Amish first to join us on stage. Amish, described as India's first literary pop star, Amish's unique combination of crackling storytelling, religious symbolism, and profound philosophies made him an overnight publishing phenomenon. An IIM Calcutta graduate, he left his 14-year-old career in finance after the release of his first book, Immortals of Melua, to become a full-time writer. His four books, Immortals of Melua, Secret of the Nagas, Oath of the Vayaputras, and Sign of Ikshvaku, have sold over 3.5 million copies in the last 5 years. And from what I can make out, Amish, who gets more and more difficult to get through to nowadays, is working really, really hard on his next book. Amish, please. Anyway. Wherever, it's okay. The next, you know, I'm calling out the names of the authors in the order in which we had them for the Write India, and how we fixed them for Write India in that particular order is we really left it to them. Whichever month suited them the best, we gave them that particular month. So I'm reading out the names also in that order. Chetan Bhagat is not with us. He's possibly still chasing his Indian girl. So, but India's author extraordinaire. He was named among the 100 most influential people in the world by Time magazine. This IITian recently put on the feminist lens with his latest book, One Indian Girl, so that's where he is right now, I guess. I call upon Ashwin Sanghi to join us on stage. Ashwin is counted amongst India's highest-selling English fiction authors. He has written 4 novels, all bestsellers: The Rosabelle Line, Chanakya's Chant, The Krishna Key, and The Sialkot Saga. He also co-writes the Private India series of crime thrillers with James Patterson. Ashwin also mentors and edits the 13-step series of self-help books. Ashwin was included by Forbes India in their Celebrity 100 list and awarded India's Crossword Popular Choice Prize. Educated at St. Xavier's College, Mumbai, and Yale University, Ashwin is often hailed as the Indian Dan Brown. And now the bankster, Ravi Subramanian. A banker by profession and an author by avocation, Ravi is an award-winning author of 8 books. His books have been translated in multiple languages, both in India and internationally. A graduate from IIM Bangalore, India's numero uno thriller writer, Ravi is not afraid to experiment. If his first book, If God Was a Banker, was the first of its kind in the world of international banking, his latest, the bestseller She Wrote, is a romantic thriller set in the world of publishing. We are still wondering why a bankster turned romantic. He is also the author of books like Bankster, The Incredible Banker, etc. God Is a Gamer was the world's first Bitcoin thriller. He lives in Mumbai with his wife and daughter Anusha, who herself is one of India's youngest published authors. Now I think we need some beauties on stage. So Preeti Shenoy. Preeti Shenoy. Sorry. Preeti Shenoy is amongst the highest selling authors in India. She also writes a regular column in the Financial Chronicle and has won the Academia Business Excellence Award for exemplary performance in their field. She is also into illustrated journaling, portraiture, and Ashtang Yoga. With Why We Love the Way We Do, she forayed into the world of self-help and non-fiction as well. You want to stand? Okay, all right. Tuheen Sinha. Tuheen Sinha is an Indian author, content strategist, and screenwriter. Tuhin is regarded among the most prolific of the New Age Indian authors with a maverick knack to experiment with new genres. He is presently also a consultant with the Ministry for Road Transport and Highways. Ravinder is the next, but I think he's still on his way from the airport. He hasn't reached us yet, so we will introduce him. We'll introduce him anyway, and then he'll come and join us later. Ravinder Singh is a best-selling Indian author and alumnus of Indian School of Business, Hyderabad. He quit his 8-year-long IT career as a senior program manager at Microsoft. He's now a full-time author who also has a publishing startup called Black Ink, where he publishes debut authors. Durjoy Datta. Durjoy Datta is a novelist, a screenwriter, an entrepreneur and a motivational speaker, a graduate from Delhi College of Engineering and Management Development Institute. He has also written over 1,000 episodes for television. And here I must break to tell you, I happened to be in Calcutta with Durjoy Datta for the launch of his book. I helped him launch that book. Okay, all right, fine. Do I say it? Look at the way they all are warning me that his wife is here. But okay, so Ravinder Singh was also there, not just him. If that saves you. And I have never ever seen girls go as crazy as they did. That's okay, that's probably, she'll feel more proud of him. and of course, with Ravinder it was a different story because they almost tore the shirt off his back. With Durjoy they didn't do that, they stayed away. That's because your wife is here. So much. Madhuri Banerjee, please come and join us on stage. A best-selling novelist, Madhuri Banerjee is also known for being a scriptwriter, columnist, and film director, and is a national award winner. She takes inspiration from people around her and has written 8 books so far. A successful film writer with Hate Story 2, she is currently working as a television programming head at Star India. Madhuri also joined us at the workshop yesterday, and so did Ravi Subramanian. And we have another author sitting in the audience, Mahinder Jhakar, who was also part of the workshop yesterday. Jayashree Mishra, please come on stage. Author of 8 novels published by Penguin and HarperCollins in the UK, Jayashree Mishra's first novel, Ancient Promises, is now a prescribed test in several universities. She has worked at the British Board of Film Classification in London. She now lives in India and teaches creative writing. A non-fiction book on Kerala is due to be published by Westland in 2017. And in between, of course, she's written several other books, which are very interesting. The only other author apart from Chetan who was not able to make it because she is on a family holiday, and by the time we informed her she was already all set for the family trip, is Anita Nair. Anita Nair is the critically acclaimed and best-selling author of several books, which include novels, children's fiction, essays, and poetry. She has also written 2 plays and the screenplay for the movie adaptation of her novel, Lessons in Forgetting, which won the National Film Award for 2012. She was awarded the Central Sahitya Academy Award for her contribution to children's literature in 2013. Her books have been translated into 30 languages. She runs a creative writing mentorship program in Bangalore called Anita's Attic. That, ladies and gentlemen, completes our profile of 11 authors. A big hand for them, and a big thank you to all of you for being able to make it here apart from being part of the Write India family. Thank you so much. We just could not have done anything without you. Thank you. And please. Oh, okay. That's the sound of success, the click, 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 click of the cameras. And you guys, the young winners of Write India Season 1, better get used to that. As we said yesterday at the workshop, and I think Ravi said that in another 3 years or maybe 4 years, you are the guys who should be sitting here awarding the next generation of writers. Yes? So we shall be waiting for that. Now what I'm going to do is, one by one, we will invite the winners for all the authors, again going in the same sequence. Amish, I'm starting with you, of course. Amish had the passage that Amish gave to the authors, and Amish was our first author to start off Write India with. We were still a nervous lot. We were not very sure how Write India would do. In fact, I was like, you know, very sure that we'd probably not get any stories or four or five stories or something. And then Amish came on, and Amish came on board with a story with a historical background where he wanted people to research and then write. And so that scared me even further, because I thought, one, people may not want to write a short story and send it across in such a short time. Second, they need to research with the historical background. So how is it going to happen? But needless to say, we were amazed and shocked at the kind of stories that flew in and the number of stories that came in. Amish, I want to ask you, why did you choose to give us that theme? Did you want to give us heart attacks? Why did... Where's the mic for the authors?
No, I'm a lover of history and mythology. I don't think that's a secret, really. But to be honest, yes, actually, it's not just you. I'd run that passage through my wife as well. And she told me that perhaps this may be a little difficult for a 2,000-word story. You know, how historical fiction novels tend to become longer for a very obvious reason. Because if you're writing something in the modern age, you don't need to describe the world that much. For example, if you want to say a girlfriend and a boyfriend are going on a date, all you need to say is that they walked into, say, Cafe Coffee Day. I'm not endorsing Cafe Coffee Day. I'm just saying that they walked into a Cafe Coffee Day. Now, in the reader's mind, the entire scene is already set up. They know what a Cafe Coffee Day looks like. They know there'll be music playing. They'll know there'll be slightly overpriced coffee out there. They know there'll be other younger people around. So you don't need to describe the scene. In those two lines, you've communicated everything. And then you can just get on with the story. But in a historical novel, which is set, say, a few centuries ago, a few thousand years ago, you know, if you're saying they walked in, you know, they traveled by ship from one place to another, you need to describe the entire thing. What's a ship like? What are the sails like? You know, so it becomes much more complex. Yeah. That's why historical novels tend to become longer. And I said something which was set, a few centuries ago. But I just wanted to give this a shot. Let's see, because my wife said it'll be very difficult to write something historical, an entire story, within just 2,000 words. And you're absolutely right. The kind of stories that came in, and they actually built the scene and communicated a story which actually pulls you in into the struggles of the characters. They did so well. I was so delighted by the qualities of the stories that came in. And it truly shows the quality of writing talent that's available in India. Yeah. And if the quality is high, then you need to set the bar high. Yeah. Let's not set the bar low, because that's what makes it a challenge and makes it fun. Yes.
Yeah, so you know I was telling you the truth when I said that we have those beautiful stories. And Amish went on record actually to say that when he was reading the top 10, he forgot, in fact, that he has to select top 3 from amongst the top 10. And he said that is what short stories and stories should be all about, that you should forget yourself when you're reading them. And that's what happened.
And there were two stories at the end of which I cried.
You did, yeah, yes.
And
yes.
That shows, if you can make a reader feel emotions for a character, then it's a rocking story.
And you chose one of the stories where you cried, right?
So the story
that Amish chose was a story written by Shutapa Basu. And I invite Shutapa Basu on stage, please. Shutapa Basu is the first Write India winner. She wrote for Amish. She's a writer by profession and loves reading, traveling, gardening, watching movies, and designing interiors. Shutapa lives in New Delhi. Shutapa, we'd like you to say a few words, please.
I'm so overwhelmed that I really don't have words to express my thoughts, but I'll try. You see, I've been writing since I was about 8 or 9 years old. And I have had a staunch belief that if you can do something with passion, if you can write with passion, those words, they become alive. They have a pulsating magic which connects them to your reader. And in 2013, when I decided to give up my 27-year-old career, a high-flying corporate career, and take to writing, I wanted to know whether I was right. And then I discovered Write India. So when I entered the contest, it was not with any expectations of winning. What really was irresistible was the bait that Mr. Amish Tripathi sent out. It was so intriguing and so challenging that I just swallowed it hook, line, sinker, and the rest is history. But more than winning, what really touched me were the comments that came for my story. And that proved to me that Write India gave me the opportunity to prove what I had always believed to be true. But it didn't end there. After that, I have been a co-author for three anthologies, two poetry collections, one of them published by Microsoft. I have written several articles, features in print magazines and online magazines in the TOI blog. And this year, I have released my debut novel, a psychological thriller called Angle. And there is a novella and novel baking in the oven. But through all these intervening months, who held my hand was Write India. Whenever I turned to them for advice, for guidance, whether it was Vinita, or it was Surabhi, or it was Gunjan, or it was Kalpana, they were always there, generously, graciously extending that help. And that is what is Write India. I'm so proud and so honored to be a part of Write India family. And being a publishing professional, I think I have the experience to say that in the history of Indian writing in English, there has never been such a magnificent literary venture as Write India. It has given us a platform where established, successful, celebrity writers whom we read but could not reach, they connected with us, the aspiring writers. It incited hundreds of writers all over the nation. It inspired them, and it also made them, encourage them to continue writing for 11 nail-biting months of suspense and excitement. That is what is Write India. So I would like not just the winners, but all the writers who have participated in the Write India contest to applaud this brilliant concept, which is Vinita Nangiya's brainchild, the Write India team, which executed it excellently, and of course, the galaxy of star authors who are our mentors and our support. So can we all really give them a really loud applause? Thank you so much, Write India, and we are all waiting for season 2, 3, 4, 5. Thank you.
Thank you, Shudupa.
Sorry, before you carry on, if I can just say, I forgot one thing. All of us should give a round of applause to Vinita. She's the heart and soul of this program.
Thank
it was
you.
Her idea. She actually drove it. So congratulations, Vinita, and thank you for this wonderful
work. Thank you so much. Of
course,
I have a wonderful team at Times of India and all of you with me, which is why any of this happened. Thank you so much. Chetan isn't here, but we move on to Chetan's winner, Nainesh Jadwani. And I would request Amish to please present Nainesh's award to him. And Nainesh is a software engineer from Mumbai, and he's the winner for author Chetan Bhagat, like I said. Apart from writing, his passion lies in music and cycling. You know, there were a lot of stories which were like, they had a twist in the tale at the end, and those like were really dramatic and very interesting, and Nainesh was one of them. And later in the evening today, we are going to have a dramatized reading of Nainesh's story, again selected out of a number of stories. We gave the stories of all the winners and then asked which one could be read out best in a dramatic manner, and his story was the one selected. Later in the evening, we'll have that. Nainesh, a few words, please.
Thank you, Vinita, and thank you for the prize. So I'd like to say that I think Write India has basically cornered me. Why? Because I had a lot of excuses last year to not write. I thought, I don't write good. Who's going to read my work? It's difficult to publish. And one by one, each of my excuses was literally destroyed by Vinita's initiative, because now I got exposure to such amazing authors. I got to realize that nobody's born with the talent. It's all hard work. Now, the only thing between me and writing well is hard work. And the only thing I have to do is write, that's all.
Thank you, Nainesh, and congratulations once again. Now we move on to Ashwin Sanghi's winner. But before that, we are going to ask Ashwin Sanghi what he thought, his personal experiences with the entire contest.
Shall I just take off?
Yes, take off. 10, 9, 8, 7, like your story, like your prompt said.
No, I must tell you, I loved the experience. And this sounds cliched, but it wasn't. Frankly, the entries that came up, as you recall, the opening passage that I had given basically was the passage which could be used for a thriller.
Yes, absolutely.
And so when I was looking at it, I was simply looking for something that would thrill me. And I was very, very pleasantly surprised. I've always believed that it's so difficult when you're given a blank piece of paper, because at that moment, you're almost playing God, because you can write anything at that point of time. And the other part of it, of course, is that I'm not looking for writing. I've seen in my own life that the books that actually sell are not necessarily good writing, but good stories.
True.
So there's a huge difference between great storytelling and great writing. So when I was looking at the finally, I think if I'm not mistaken, I worked a little harder than Amish and the others, because I eventually took 20 stories. To
you
read.
Get the cat out of the bag.
Yeah. So I think I was one of your more hardworking authors. Yeah. And
yes.
Am I right?
Yes, absolutely. So all our authors.
I'm just trying to.
Involved.
No, no. I'm just trying to acknowledge that I was a little harder than the others.
Yeah, you were.
Yeah. So
what I do acknowledge is.
My slot has been taken over. There was someone who read 30.
That's anyway. What I was going to say. Other authors did it. You were one of those who kept insisting, do you want me to read more? You can get. Do you want me to read more? You can get. Yes.
But having said that, Vinita, I think what ended up happening was that when I was reading, you know, I've always believed that the mark of a good story, and people ask me this very often at lit fests and at press conferences, that what makes a bestseller? And I've always maintained that there are three things. Step one, your first para should suck your reader into the story. Step two, along the way, there should be enough hooks which propel the reader into the remaining part of your story. So it becomes compelling. And the third part of it, to be a bestseller, is that your last para should be such that the reader looks out for your next book. So if you can do those three things, then you're a bestseller. Frankly, there were more than one story in the lot which fell into that particular definition, which was the moment of illumination, enlightenment, as it were. So to that extent, I believe obviously the hard work had already been done by you guys in terms of sifting through the thousands that had come. But the lot that eventually came to me was outstanding. Was not just good, it was outstanding. So I think we are at a moment where we have the option of being able to create some wonderful, wonderful storytellers going forward. Yeah? So thank you for all of those people who submitted stories. Just one final, for those who are here. I have no background, neither does Amish, I think, in creative writing or in literature. So people ask me, what's your qualification as an MBA finance? How do you write? I said, during my growing up years, one of my greatest qualifications that my mother told me was that I was a very good liar. I was a very good liar. And frankly, anyone who can spin a yarn
has
all the makings of a storyteller.
Okay.
So in case there are a bunch of you out there who wonder whether you can actually start out on that road, please do, as long as you're good liars.
Yes.
I'll just add one more thing. I thought he was about to say that, because I know he reads a lot as well. I love reading too. It's one of the things that I believe. You want to be a good writer, you must be a good reader. Read as much as you can, because that's how you learn skills from others. That's how you learn storytelling. Yeah. That's how you learn about different cultures. So reading is certainly a very important.
Yes, yes, Amish, we know that you wanted to make clear you don't fall into the liar category.
Actually, what Amish is talking about is very much related to lying. Because if you have to tell a lie, then you should tell that lie as close to the truth as possible. And the only way you can do that is by reading.
Is by reading, yeah. Yesterday, somebody said at the workshop, there's nothing called inspiration. Inspiration is only plagiarism. So we call upon Keena Shree. Keena is Ashwin Zangi's winner. She's an HR professional from Lucknow who stood first for Ashwin. Keena is a strong believer in the power of storytelling and cooks up stories for her little ones every night. So cooks up has again the indication of lying, right? Cooks up stories.
Well, honestly, I do not have an acceptance speech. I'll go straight to the point because I wrote the story from heart and I hope I'm not blocking you. Okay. Whatever comes to mind, I'll have to say. Actually, you know, I'm not a very nice person. I'm not mushy, sweet, honey-coated. No, I'm not. I'm actually very restless, very chaotic. I struggle, I mull over. And I've often wondered, all this while, why have I worn this badge of chaos with such pride? I have no answer. In fact, it was when Riot India happened that I received my answers. Chaos is important. Chaos gives us stories. I met all of these mentors, stalwarts in the industry, so-called authors, and found they were equally chaotic and restless dreamers. And thank you, because now I have a huge family of restless people who keep on inspiring me. Well, tonight is the night when Vinita and her Write India team, they have a fairy tale book launch for us. They call us next-gen authors. Now, come on. When they say next-gen authors, my heart skips a beat. And I really wish how this moment can stop forever. But like I learned in the workshop yesterday, like I have learned from my mentors, the road ahead is not easy. It's not going to be a bed of roses. My takeaway from Write India campaign is that despite hard ways coming across, despite the troubles that we are going to face, the critiques that are going to come up, and the venture not being rewarding every time, yet if there is a story inside that needs to be told, needs to be written, it must bleed on paper, because that's what storytelling is all about. Well, I'll sum up my feelings in this one Urdu ka sher, if you would allow me the liberty to speak in Urdu. Kaun kehta hai aasman mein surakh nahi hota? Kaun kehta hai aasman mein surakh nahi hota? Ek patthar tabiyat se uchhalo yaro. Thank you. Thank you. In total gratitude. Thank you, really.
So now we add onto the stage a chair and a guy to sit on it, Ravinder Singh. A round of applause for Ravinder. There are people there as well. Just in case somebody feels left out. All right. So now we move on to Ravi Subramanian. And something interesting happened when, we were reading Ravi's stories. And then the final 10 came up and Ravi had read through more than 10. And he had read through many more than 10 as well. So when he... Yes, trying to be fair and balanced to everybody. Yeah. So anyway, I just in case I need you guys again. Never know. So there were two issues that came up. One was that the winner that both Ravi and we thought the person who should be the winner, who had already been a winner for Chetan Bhagat, as in the second or the third position. What was it? Third position. So we didn't know whether to take, to give first position to someone who had already been awarded a third position for one of the early authors. And the second thing that happened was, and I've already told you that Ravi's passage was like around infidelity. And the second thing that happened is that a 14-year-old wrote a story on infidelity, and she was amongst the first three. So we didn't know what to do. We didn't believe that a 14-year-old could have written that story. And we thought what to do about it. And what if tomorrow somebody else says, this is our story, she couldn't have written it. We said she couldn't have. So we made calls to her home. We spoke to her dad. We spoke to her family. And we asked her, we said, are you willing to give it in writing? You've done it. And what if we get into some trouble? So then, we did all that. Ravi spoke to her. We spoke to her and the parents and everything. And ultimately, we realized that, yes, she has written that story. And we said, okay, fine, yes, we will give her an award. Prapti Panda is sitting here with us. Prapti, please stand up and acknowledge the applause. 14-year-old girl writing and winning story on infidelity. Yes. And after that, she wrote many more, of course, very good stories. But she did not make it to the top 10 again. She's been very disappointed about that, but the stories were good. Thank you, Prapti, and wish you all the best. We will call you later. But the winner, the first winner for Ravi is Tishampati Sen. Tishampati, please come on stage. Tishampati is a lawyer by profession, hailing from New Delhi. He has a great passion for stories and loves finding anecdotes and stories all around him. He loves reading and writing and dotes on his Labrador, Simba. Tishampati, a quick word from you, and then we still have to get Ravi to talk.
So, many years ago when I just started working, me and my colleague, we used to sit 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock at night looking at documents. And we used to tell each other, yaar, teko pata hai, I have a story in my mind, we're going to write this book, and we're going to, that's our way out. We're going to write this, and then we'll be famous. Of course, we didn't. We just carried on with life, and we struggled, and we, worked. What Write India did was it allowed me the opportunity to put words down on paper and actually have a story. So I still remember when the YouTube video came out with Ravi sir acknowledging that I was the winner. My wife, of course, pasted it on the whole world for everyone to see. And my friend called me up and he said, yaar, I can't believe you actually wrote the story. I mean, that itself was the achievement. So winning is, of course, a great feeling. But the fact that I have a story of my own, that was the bigger high for me. So congratulations to Write India and thank you, everyone.
Ravi has all through been someone who had a lot to say about Write India, a lot of ideas, a lot of suggestions, and he's been in touch with us all through and for every author. He would pop up on the Twitter chats for almost every author, and a lot of authors did that. He did, yes, and he supported everyone. A lot of the other authors also did that. That's one beautiful thing that I realized through Write India, that most of the authors really support each other. And as we were talking yesterday, there doesn't seem to be any dirty politics in this industry at all. At least I didn't see any of it. It's a beautiful relationship they all share, and we benefited from that truly. And they really supported each other. And I just had to tell them that there's somebody on a Twitter chat and they would all come in there and support each other. They did that. So, Ravi, I'm also going to shoot a straight question to you and not really get into other interesting questions we would like to ask about why a banker turned romantic and all. So just tell us about your experience of Write India, the stories that you read, and how difficult was it for you to select the best ones?
Well, I'll tell you why a banker turned...
I just said that I would stay away from that.
I'll tell you why a banker turned romantic.
Okay, fine. So don't answer. Don't answer the Write India question. You tell us why you turned romantic and why you gave the passage on infidelity. You can ask.
I just have a three-word answer. Okay, yeah. It's called midlife crisis. Okay, so on a serious note, I started writing. Or I wrote a romantic thriller largely because I feel that any author who does not really challenge himself is not doing justice to his craft. And if you are a good storyteller, you should be able to tell a good story across different genres. And that's what I tried to do when I wrote a romantic thriller. And then when I looked at people to my right and people to my left, and I said, okay, fine, let me try and see if I can And Durja was always threatening to write a thriller. So I said, let me now write a romantic thriller and try and see if we can get into his space. So that's one of the reasons. But honestly, on Write India, experience was fabulous. I didn't expect the number of stories that we got.
We didn't.
I didn't expect the kind of stories that we got. Prapti Panda was a surprise to me.
Yeah, absolutely.
The passage that I had given was a very complicated one. And she spun a tale around it, which was not really infidelity, but kind of bordering on it. So it kind of just turned out to be a very nice story. And which points to the fact that if you have a fertile mind, then you can spin a story around any damn thing in life. And I think that's where what you said comes into mind. You need to spin a yarn. And if you're able to do that, you'll be a great storyteller. And if you have the power of observation, you'll be a great storyteller. I completely enjoyed my experience. Those midnight Twitter chats when you launch a story, when you launch a passage, when you announce winners, those were all extreme fun moments for all of us. In fact, I think the authors also enjoyed it a lot more than you guys did. So thank you for making those 11 months great for us. Mm-hmm.
The midnight, as all right, and those who participated in Write India know, we would always launch a passage at midnight. We would always announce results at midnight, and we would always, shut the contest at midnight. So all of us used to be awake, all of us used to be on Twitter, and it was great fun. It was like Cinderella hour for all of us, and it turned out beautifully always. I would like to call on stage Prapti Panda now. Prapti, please come up on stage and... Ravi has a special something for you. She is real, actually. He actually took permission from her father to, give her one of the top three awards, considering the passage. Thank you, Prapti. Wish you all the best. Preeti Shenoy. The winner for Preeti Shenoy was Sama Vasaria. Sama quit her job to freelance so she could find time to discover her interests, and it is during this period that she started to write her first fictional story. Sama stays in Mumbai. Please come on stage. Words on the mind, please. Would you take a...
Okay, can I be heard? Yes, I'll make this short and sweet. So whatever every winner has said is true. Of course, the whole movement has opened an entire new platform for aspiring writers like me, who find it really hard to get a foothold. And a big, big thank you to Vinita ma'am to suddenly just put us out there. Suddenly we're on the map. Suddenly I can reach out. I'm meeting people who I couldn't even dream to ever even know personally. Somebody knows me. Preeti ma'am knows me. She'll remember me. And what is really important is what I will take back is acknowledgement. It's very, very heartening to know that in this field I am acknowledged, and what you have given us is, I don't know where we will go. Many of us moonlight as writers and we have different jobs, and I don't know from here how many people will actually become best-selling authors, but we will always remember feeling acknowledged, feeling accomplished, and it's very difficult. I personally believe that it's very easy to... Failure is a wrong word, but not succeed in a field like writing. It's not easy. Not many make it. But with Write India, you have made all of us feel that we have made it in some way or the other. We have made
it. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Preeti, finally we hear a female voice from the stage apart from mine. So, yeah, give this also. Just keep it. Just like this. in case there's an interaction. So Preeti, I think we had a wonderful experience with the passage that you gave, and your passage talked about a lady waiting for SMS to fall into her cell phone, and the SMS wouldn't arrive, and she kept looking at it again and again, and she saw that the guy was online, and yet he was not replying to her messages at all. And it seems that the youngsters were able to relate to that very well, and we did get in a lot of stories for you. So when you read the stories, were they what you expected them to be? Do you think that the kind of writing that people did for you was the kind of writing they would have read by you? I think a lot of writers did try to do that. So if they're writing for Amish, they tried to write a bit like him. If they're writing for Ashwin, they tried to write a bit like him. Did you feel that that was happening for your stories?
First of all, I would like to clarify one thing. What the guy was doing to her was scene zoning her, That's the term. So, no, the stories that I got were not really the kind of stories that I would write. Now, I had a very simple criteria because the stories were amazing. I really enjoyed reading all the stories. And it was really hard to pick three. How do you pick three stories? So, I had a very simple criteria. I said, I'll read these stories and I'll wait for 3 or 4 days. And then I'll see which one stuck in my mind. Because obviously, they are the ones which made an impact. So I picked a story which made me feel. I had to feel something. I had to feel some emotion. Because there were stories which had great writing techniques, which had language, which had, everything going. But the story didn't work for me. Because I think, like Ashwin said, unless it makes you feel something, you're not going to relate to that story. So for me, it had to have that emotional appeal. And the winners I picked, those stories did have the emotional appeal, and I had a very hard time picking, who would be the first, who would be the second, who would be the third. That was very hard for me. And the entire experience has been amazing. And one thing which I want to tell everyone, in any creative endeavor, I think it's very important to shut your monkey. I think all of us have this monkey sitting on our shoulder, this invisible monkey, which tells you, think of your third grade teacher or your fourth grade teacher who said this is not good, and a big, a C or a D or say 2 on 10 or what. So when you're writing, all of those insecurities are going to come to the forefront. So it's very important for you to shut your monkey. And I think that's what each and everyone present here has done. It's not that, someone has that magical power to tell a tale and someone doesn't have it. It's just that the ones who write are the ones who manage to shut their monkeys. And more than anything, it's the fear of failing. What if I fail? But the thing is, what if people like it? So I think it's very important to write. And I think Write India has given each one a fantastic platform to come out there month after month. And I think it's a great thing.
Thank you. Thank you, Preeti. Our next Write India author was Tuhin. And for Tuhin, the winner is Aarti Shah. Aarti is a researcher and writer, and she won the first position for him. She lives in Mumbai, loves reading, watching films and American sitcoms, cooking exotic dishes, dabbling in facts about history, art and architecture. Aarti, how many authors did you participate for? I must tell you that there were, out of the entire lot of 25,000 participants, 25,000 stories we got, there were about 18 people who wrote for all 11 authors. 18 of them wrote for all 11 authors.
Hello. I wrote for 4.
Okay. Yeah.
Durjoy and the 3 ladies in the end.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. I'll keep it short, just like the short stories. The word anthology excites me the most, and I love short stories, and I think I have the hugest collection of short story anthologies with me, dating from 15th century, and the second thing that wanted me to write was being a Mumbai, the Times of India is a big institution for me sitting there in Fort. I have lived in Mumbai all my life, so it is like, the paper on my table every morning. And TOI is, for me, a hugely respected and credible organization. And the thing was to be associated with my work being read by authors of eminence and being validated. That was what got me writing for Times of India. And thank you all so much. Thank you to him. Thank you, Vinita. Thank you, everybody, for giving me those prompts and those deadlines. And I wrote a different style for each one. And that, for me, was an achievement because I discovered something that I could write in different styles. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Tohin, I'm not going to ask you what you thought about the stories or what you thought about Right India. I'm going to ask you, how do you balance being an author, a script writer, and now half a politician? How do you manage doing all that?
Well, I just like to surprise myself. So in as much as my readers keep guessing what my next book or which genre my next book is going to be on around, I'm probably as confused. So the prompt that I gave for Write India was a relationship saga, which a relationship story, which I had attempted after 9 years, because my first book, which came out in 2006, was a similar book, that thing called Love. And this prompt was from there. So in the same way that I kind of like to surprise myself as an author, I like to do different things in life.
So people, along with guessing what will your next book be, they also guess which hat you will don next. What are you going to be next?
That's for me to know and you to find out.
Yes. Thank you so much, Tohin, for also being a very supportive author who was with us throughout. And now we move on to Jacinta Saldana has not been able to make it today. She's the only winner who wasn't able to make it. Jacinta was winner for Ravinder Singh. And she works as a personal secretary at an MNC in Mumbai. Jacinta loves writing. Having written for most of the Write India authors, she aspires to become a published author herself. But she's out of the country, and so she couldn't make it today here. You know, very interesting thing happened because Ravinder and Durjoy came together. Now, this was the month of January, so we had to get one of them in Jan and the other in February. And February, as we all know, is Valentine's Day. And as we all know, both these authors, you know, we just couldn't decide who to put in the month of February. So a big debate went on, and then ultimately what tipped the scales in Durjoy's favor was that we heard whispers that he's getting married in February. So then we said, okay, fine, February belongs to him. And we gave January to Ravinder Singh, who was also a prime candidate.
Maine de diya, Durjoy, tu ja.
Achha kiya.
My gift. Aur teri shaadi mein aaunga bhi fir main.
Yes, Ravinder attended Durjoy's wedding, I believe. And I would have expected, this is another revelation, I would have expected them to be rivals. They are not, it seems. I mean, they may be competitive rivals in the field of romance writing, but they are great friends. And Ravinder, I want you to talk a bit about, the kind of writing you do, why are girls, like, you know, we said this before you came in, why do they throw themselves at you wherever you go?
Both of us.
No, you. His wife is here. So I'd like you to stand up because I think people here cannot see you.
I am an author by chance who had now become an author by choice now. I just feel that it's much more writing than developing program course, which is why I quit my job. I don't write sci-fi, fantasy, different. I just write about stories that come naturally to me. To me, the boy next door, the girl next door, I keep observing what's happening in and out of the circle. And real life situations drive me to talk about them. So the last book that I wrote about is on extramarital affair. We were talking about the infidelity, but I have a very different take on it. And the reason I chose to write about it is because I'm now a married man, so I can completely understand the world of extramarital affairs and perhaps the reasons behind why so many people... So I can only write about things that I see in that vicinity. Maybe as a bachelor, I would not have written a book like that or talked about an open relationship. But something that comes naturally to me, the thought process, ye yahan pe ho raha, I just love the idea to write. But I'm a lazy writer who takes long amount of time to write. I wish I can write like Durjoy does. He churns out books every time. So that's one thing that I need to learn from others. But yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Ravinder.
Yeah, go ahead. Can I ask you a
question? When you said, now I understand why people engage in extramarital affairs.
You
had a very sheepish look on your face.
You can't even see my face, dude. So I'll just tell you a little example when I say that. I'm a very honest person. I'll just give you an example. So for example, if a head of getting into the school of marriage, if I'm just driving a car and I happen to see this gorgeous woman entering my society, I could just look at her. But now what changes that when you're a married guy and your wife is sitting next to you, the gorgeous woman is again passing by and then you hesitate to, you know, look at her at that point in time. So this is little difference. And then one day I just told my wife, I really want to look at that gorgeous woman because she's just passing out. But because I happened to speak, then she said, it's okay, you can. So these sort of little things when I felt like, and I then delve into other people's life, what they're talking about, it just came naturally to me. Oh, there was. It all went to Ashley Madison and Lord Indra to Ahalya. So from I started from Kali Yuga and landed into Treta and Dwapar Yuga. And Amish would give more insights onto it. But yeah, this attraction was there in that age also. And the kings of gods could not have it. We are mere mortals. So I chose to write about it. Thank you.
But Ravinder, one warning. When your wife says that you're free to look, please don't take her seriously ever. Just never do that. It is a test.
I just want...
Where? I didn't see anyone.
See, that scene may be a bigger reason for me to go and write. It's just kind of an approval. That you haven't said anything today, I'm writing a book. Because I wanted to write this thing.
Okay. So, Ravinder's winner, like we said, is not here today. We move on to Durjoy. And before I call on stage Roshan Radhakrishnan, Durjoy had written a story, a prompt, a very unique prompt, where a girl has two hearts. So she has two hearts, and because of that, she's very different. And now everybody is eager to take away one heart of hers to save someone else in need of a heart. And so he and the person who won it is an anesthesiologist. So I was pretty... not really surprised at that, because he's written a beautiful story where he talks about, you know, the angle from a doctor's angle also. So, but Durjoy, why you were getting married? Why did you have to write a story of a woman with two hearts? I mean, what was the connection there?
First of all, I'm so happy that you're calling these authors next-gen authors, because it's been 8 years that I've been writing. And there are only two things that people describe me as. He's a next-generation author.
Okay, instead.
That hasn't changed in 10 years. And he's young and upcoming. It started in 2008. It's like I'm in an elevator. I'm just coming up. So thank you for introducing 111 more next-gen authors. An interesting thing happened. When I was writing this prompt, I was working on my first thriller. And it was giving me pains. Like, I did not know how to go about it. So when I started writing the prompt, I wanted to write something which is like really hard, where you can't make a story out of it, because I want to be nasty to other people as well, because it was happening to me. And then when I read the prompt, like a week before you release the thing, I read it and I was like, did I write this thing? And before that, all these authors have already, you know, they had released, the entries had come in, and they had come in thousands. And I was like, nobody's going to finish this story. And I was like, I should change it. And I gave a list of really strict guidelines. Like, I was intentionally being mean to the participants. and I did not want a love story. I very strictly said I do not want a love story, but still people found a love story in this two-heart thing. It was not supposed to be a love story, but you know, everyone has said it's a very brilliant experience, a wonderful experience, a learning experience. I second all of that. But it was also a very depressing experience for me. Every time I read a story, and I was like, you know, these guys write better than me. And you know, for the longest, I sat on the three stories that I shortlisted, and I was like, I'm not picking one author, because the other two are going to grab me by the collar and ask me, can you write this? And my answer would have been no. Like, for the longest, I wanted to do eeny, meeny, miny, moe. But then I waited for a couple of weeks, and then whichever story stayed with me, I picked that.
Yes, that's something that is that I did as well. Read a story and wait for a while, it stays with you and it's a good story. So we call on stage Roshan Radhakrishnan, Durjoy's winner. Roshan is an anesthesiologist, doctor by profession. In his free time, he blogs and plays a chauffeur to his pet beagle, Snoopy. He's a self-confessed TV sitcom addict. Roshan, a doctor and a writer.
Yes.
please tell us something about your writing experiences?
I'll keep it short. Probably related to what Mrs. Preeti Shenoy said, the monkey on my back is always time. I work usually a 100-hour shift a week, and I don't get time usually to write for myself. We don't get a lot of support in our field to move away from anesthesiology or to move away from medicine. As far as writing is concerned, I wrote my first short story when I was in 8th standard. I wrote the next longer version of that, probably it was a spoof on Star Trek versus Star Trek, the Next Generation in 9th standard. And always you hear the one sentence, yeah, this guy's creative, but it'll fade away with time. I entered the medical field, and I have actually sat in the dissection hall and written a skit on my friends. They love it. Some of them still have the photostat of that. But again, that was the same thing on the back of your mind. Once you become something, a specialist in your field, you're not going to have time for this. That's continued. When I joined as a PG, when I became an anesthesiologist, I had to face the same thing. We used to work 38-hour shifts, sleep for 8 hours, and then begin the next 38-hour shift. I still found time to write. And that's my one advice, which I think anyone else who's scared to write or who feels that they are not worthy of writing. My first story as an 8th standard student would not pass muster anywhere. Over the years, I've written and I've evolved. But I've had the support of friends all over. As a blogger, I've had comments come from all over, and that helps us. We listen to the feedback and we get better with time.
Yes.
If I'm standing here today, it's because there's at least 1,000 comments from people starting from my childhood who have helped me learn where my flaws are and helped me get better at that.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, this for me turns what was subjective into what is objective. What is subjective is everyone telling me I'm creative. What is objective is this paper and their acceptance.
Thank you.
May I add something, Vinita?
Yeah.
May I add
something? Of course, of course.
So I just want to say something. Roshan and I go back a long way. You know, much before I was a published author, I was a blogger. So I didn't have anything to my name. I hadn't published anything to my name. And I used to read Roshan's blog,
wow,
which was God Ears.
Didn't know that,
and I used to blog. And at that time, I wanted to be anonymous. So I had, you know, put my name of my blog as just a mother of two. And we would read each other's blogs and we would leave comments on each other's blogs. And then when my first book got published, Roshan was there and the entire blogging community was there because all of us had interacted on our blogs. So it's especially, I'm really happy to see him as a winner. It was a real surprise. I didn't know that he was one of the winners. It's a real surprise. And to this day, both of us continue blogging. My blog is still I'm alive and kicking, and I blog regularly, and so does Roshan. And so if anyone wants to start off, I would recommend blogging as a great experience simply because of the reach. You know, you reach international, you reach an international audience. Like, I've had people sending me gifts from Sao Paulo, from Brazil, from Japan, all over the world. So with the click of a button, use technology to your advantages. That's one thing which I want to tell, and that's the one thing which I wanted to share, that blogging is a great platform.
Sure. Thank you, Preeti. Thank you. And now, sorry, Jayshree.
Sorry, a question for you, Vinita. How on earth could you use Durjoy's wedding month to get him to be the judge? And he's got other things
yes,
to do at
actually.
Midnight rather you than know, tweeting.
Would you believe
I'm a very dedicated part of this. I'm the most dedicated one. Sorry, Ashwin.
I agree. If you're using your wedding month.
But would you believe it? I never even thought of that. This is the first time. No, really. This is the first time I thought of it.
Yeah.
That yes, yeah. But he also didn't let us feel that he was like too caught up to
He's
go through the entries.
Wife. Yes. Wife. Yes.
Yeah, she
tonight.
Is.
Yeah.
Did you hate me? Did you really, really hate me?
Oh.
Ow. Why is that so? No. Okay.
No, no, it's a long distance shadi. Don't.
Yeah.
No extramarital stuff happening. No research.
Yeah. It's complicated. Absolutely, yes. It's complicated, yes.
Just a long distance
shot.
I must tell you,
it's Bombay. Not be unfair, it's not be no, but let me tell you, Bombay Times is here, so we have our headlines for tomorrow morning. Okay, right. You know, I'm really sorry for allowing the ladies, I mean, for making the ladies keep quiet for so long and leaving them for the last. But that's the way we went. One by one, and yes, the best for the last. I didn't want to say that because then I thought you guys would get upset. So glad you said it, Amish. Yeah. So now we come to Madhuri Banerjee. Madhuri's prompt was on love jihad, and again we got a lot of entries for that. And Shachi Desai. From Vadodara, a student from Vadodara, is the one who won the first position. And this was while she was preparing for her board exams. She aspires to become an author. Shachi, please come onto the stage. Shachi, very quickly tell us, how did you write while you were preparing for your board exams and why did you do so? Was Madhuri the only one you wrote for?
No, I wrote for Ashwin sir, Tuhin sir, Ravindra sir, Dvijay.
My God.
Actually the first...
Why not for me, yeah?
Because I'm getting to that. Actually, when you first announced to write India, my mom told me to participate, and I'm like, I'm not going to do this. There's no way I'm this good. And then my friend came up to me, and she's like, you should write. So for some of the months, I wrote. And then for March, my dad actually made me promise, don't write, study. Okay. And then I was studying, and the prompt was in my head, and I had a story spinning. And then I read about that there was the extra time in April. So I gave my JE on April 3rd. And then on 4th and 5th, I wrote the story.
Wow. Yeah, great. Thank you. Madhuri told us yesterday that 90% of the stories written by authors for their first book are autobiographical. Right? That's what you said, right, at the workshop. And then I asked her the name of her first book, which is?
Losing my virginity and other dumb ideas.
So, okay, all right. So I will not be unfair. I won't ask you about that, Madhuri. Stop blushing. So what has your experience as a writer who started working for television now, who's into script writing, who's also written for a movie? What do you think is the connection between them all? How did you get into all this? Was it all planned or did you just kind of keep going along?
I don't think writing is ever planned as such. I think we all have stories in our head, and I think all of them also spin yarns, tell lies, have affairs, and then they can write about it, I guess. So we're all writers here. Some of us are authors, some of us are columnists, and I'm now working with television, and so I'm finding writers there. So I've kind of gone to the dark side where I'm actually adapting books for television.
What has been the most exciting part of this journey for you?
For Write India has been the... It's been an eye-opening thing for me because I've been to many lit fests and I've interacted with a lot of young writers in television as well as Bollywood. But the quality of writing that I found in Write India was absolutely incredible. I wanted to read more and more stories, and the prompt that I gave was a bit scary because we thought that, some fundamentalists would come after us because it was a Hindu-Muslim kind of a prompt. The people came up with such interesting thrillers, romances, they spinned it back from old era to current era, and I didn't give too many rules, I think. So I said, just be open to the whole thing. And it was wonderful, the stories that they came up with. And I really thought that I would love to take these writers and put them onto television and make a Bollywood movies from their stories,
yes,
as well.
So that would be wonderful for them. In fact, some of our authors have, our celebrity authors here, have suggested that, that they would like to look at their winners and maybe beyond that at other winners as well, to be able to work with them at some point or the other. Some of the authors have suggested that, and I'm sure that will come true. We will also be bringing out a lot of books with our best stories, and which means like many, many books we will be bringing out.
Thank you, Vinita, for giving us this opportunity to interact with writers of the next gen, and not just Durjoy.
Thank you. Yes. Not just Durjoy. Yeah. 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 And then the tides changed, and we had on board Jayashree Mishra, and then came Anita Nair. And somehow the tide had changed, and we'd got on board slightly more serious writers. Are you upset at that? Okay, all right. Okay, I started a riot here. So, yeah, and we were also a little scared because we thought, okay, here are the very popular commercial authors who have, you know, a lot of readers. They hate to call them fans. And a lot of readers who have been, you know, writing for them, and we got very good response. And we were a little unsure because now we thought the kind of stories expected by Jayashree or by Anita later would be slightly, maybe, you know, different stories from the ones that we've been having so far. But would you know it, we were surprised yet again, and we got quite a few stories for both of them. And Jayashree, would you like to tell us how you felt about the Write India experience, the kind of stories you got and the prompt you gave?
Well, I think, like was mentioned earlier, I tried to give a prompt that might appeal to the kind of person who would read my books. And I get people coming up to me all the time. I write sort of emotional narratives. I'm not sure how literary they are, but I mean, we've had this argument in the past. I'm kind of borderline. But I do get people coming up to me quite a bit saying, oh, your so-and-so book had me crying all night. And I don't know whether they're thanking me for this terrifying experience of crying all night or whether they actually hate me for it. But it does that kind of thing to people, my writing. And I think at least three or four of my books have that very kind of heart-tugging kind of poignant storyline. And so I wanted to see whether I could pull that kind of writing out of the Write India people who were going to be writing for me. So my prompt was quite clearly directed. I think some were a lot more open and people could take it this way or that. I thought mine was a bit more focused on the experience of loss. I thought that loss, losing someone or something that's precious to you, is bound to be kind of heartrending, isn't it? I mean, you can't possibly make something positive out of it. So with that sort of confidence, I sent it off. But you know how they say when you write a book, it just, you send it out there, you've lost all control of it, and it starts reading differently to different people? It just, from all the feedback you get, I'm sure all the writers here will agree, you know, what you think the book is going to mean to somebody sometimes isn't that at all. They come back, they put their own experiences into it. I didn't know that a paragraph or a prompt could do that as well. So that was a very strange sort of experience for me to find with the kind of entries that we got, was that there were still all kinds of meditations. It was not necessarily on loss. And in fact, the prize-winning story that you're going to be introducing in a minute, sort of stood out from the very first read. I think I knew that I'd found something really special. And that isn't exactly about loss. I mean, you'll all go home and, you know, read the book tonight, so you'll know what I'm talking about. But it was a very mature, very empathetic, very sensitive kind of story of mature people. And that was what, I mean, I thought I had the 95-year-old writer who wrote for Ashwin. I thought, hey, my 90-year-old is writing for me. All this empathy and wisdom and all of that was shining through in this story about mature love and about a couple who've been through many, their backstories were beautifully told, very subtly introduced, and yet who find something together. And then there's a bit of a heartbreaking thing as well. So loss, yes, but it was a jolly good story. It really, really was. And the characters were so appealing, they stayed forever. I still remember the characters. They've stayed forever. So it was, I think, talent just shines through. And when you have a competition like this, it was an absolutely brilliant initiative. And I'm so glad to know there's going to be a season 2 and a season 3 and a season 4,
yes,
because we're not going to lose all those people out there who are slogging away, writing and reading and doing all those things that we thought we'd lost forever with the digital age coming through. So
Well done, really, to you thank and you. The Right India family, and for bringing us all together.
Yes, absolutely.
We've
yes.
had some great thank friendships you. Have formed.
You're going to, you, all these stories, as the authors talk about them and they read the stories, you're going to be reading them all in the book we are going to be launching in a few minutes from now. The book is going to be available. It's on sale after the launch. Now we call on stage Jayashree's winner, the one she has praised so much, the story, Ramya Vivek. Ramya, please come on to stage. Coimbatore-based software developer turned aspiring writer Ramya spends her day either writing at her desk or running after her two little boys, aged 5 and 2. She won for Jayashree, of course. She is a foodie, blogger, compulsive bookworm, and loves spending lazy evenings gardening with her kids. Ramya, a few words from you. A few quick words from you. I can see the audience getting a little restless. We will launch the book in just a few more minutes. Please bear with us.
I'll make this as brief as possible. Many thanks to Jayashree ma'am for her lovely words of encouragement. Okay. Yeah, let me reveal something over here. I almost didn't attempt Jayashree Mishra ma'am's prompt. Because the reason being, I had attempted most of the other prompts before this, and I really didn't make it to the shortlist. So I kind of had, I was very close to, you know, giving up. So, but I'm glad I didn't give up. I persisted, and that's the only reason I'm here with such great, great, amazing people and some of India's best writing new talent over here. So then, my takeaway from all this is only this. Please don't ever give up on your dream. Because success could be closer to you than what you really think. So that's about it.
Thank you. Thank you, Ram. There is definitely going to be a season 2 of Write India. We are signing up authors. And we've signed up with Ruskin Bond. We've signed up with Anand Neel Kantan, who's sitting here. And sitting here in the front row, and with Chitra Banerjee Devakarani. These are the three authors that we have signed up for season 2. And we will be signing up with more and then announcing the entire panel of Write India season 2 authors. We are also going to be launching Write India in Hindi this year. Yes. Now we come to Anita Nair's winners. She selected 2 winners and then she didn't appear herself here. So we have Vasudha Channa Gulati. Vasudha, please come onto the stage and I will request Ravinder Singh to do the honors since his winner did not come up here. So, DOI Write India winner for Anita Nair, Vasudha Channa Gulati, is a blogger and a homemaker. She loves reading, writing, swimming, cooking, and discussing books. She lives in Gurugram.
Gurugram.
Yes. And Vasudha also, she is also a multiple winner. Vasudha, who else did you win an award for? For Ravinder Singh. Oh my God, yes. So he's absolutely the appropriate guy to give you an award. So she won for Ravinder as well as for Anita.
The word that comes to my mind when I think about Write India was relevance. So I gave up my career for my children. 16 years, my son was 16 years. And I was looking for myself. I'd always thought I'll write because my mother says that from the moment I learned to read, I've been reading. My board exams, I was gifting books to myself because I had to buy them. It was a compulsive need. I had to buy my books and I would wrap them up and keep them under my bed so that I wouldn't read them. And so that was, it was always there that one day I will write. And when I saw the first ad for Write India, the day had come. I had to start. So I started with Amish's prompt. I loved it. I love history. I love the past. So I did a lot of research. When the winner was announced, I was very disappointed. I thought I'm not going to write
anymore. Not with the winner, but with not winning yourself.
With not winning, because Shutapa yeah. is a great friend.
Yeah.
So yes, she deserves it. I know that. And then I wrote for 7 other writers. When I got Ravinder's prompt, I wrote it. I was very happy with at least getting somewhere with the third, as the third winner. And I thought, now I'm not going to write. It's done. I again wrote. I wrote for Madhuri. I wrote for Jayashree. And I was doing the blogging challenge, the A to Z. So I thought Anita is not going to happen. I won't be able to do Anita Nair's, and she's someone I really admire and I really read her. But eventually I did that as well. And I didn't expect to win anything because I'd already won something. So I thought, it's not happening. I just sent it because I liked the story. My husband liked the story. He was the only one who had read it. So winning that was awesome. Yes. And Write India has given me relevance. It's given me the direction at the age that I am now to move forward, to achieve that dream that I have of writing about the past, about my family, which comes from the Northwest West frontier, and telling their stories as well.
Great, that's wonderful.
Thank you so much, all of you. You're really inspirational. All you've done for us, and Vinita ma'am, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Your dream is my dream.
Yes. Thank you. Sharing the position with Vasudha is Rohit Tandekar. Rohit is a mechanical engineer who loves singing, playing keyboard, writing poems, and working out in the gym. He lives in Mumbai. Rohit, tell me, who else did you write for? Mike. Who else did you write for?
So, I found out about the competition really late. I found out the competition only when the deadline for Anita Nair, ma'am's prompt was, yeah, okay. It's coming up. Anyway, I was giving my final year mechanical engineering exam. So, and one thing I'd like to add is I'm more hardworking, I think, than Shachi, because she wrote after her exam. I wrote before the exam.
Okay.
So one day before, I was typing away on my laptop. My mom's thinking I'm studying. Thankfully, I won. Yeah. Thankfully, I also passed without a KT. So I am a successful mechanical engineer now, along with an author.
Wonderful.
Thank you to all
Excellent.
Of you.
I was asking you who else you wrote for, because I thought if any of the other authors, I would ask them to give you the award. Okay. But you didn't. I'm going to request Jayashree Mishra to give your Rohit's award to him.